All coal licenses issued since 1993 are illegal, the Supreme Court said today, saying the process of allocations lacked transparency in the absence of a competitive bidding system. It's a verdict that could have serious consequences for the economy.
Coal allocations was the most hotly debated scam in the Lok Sabha polls. Today, the top court stopped short of cancelling the coal block allocations during NDA and UPA regimes, but termed all the allocations since 1993 as arbitrary and illegal. Coalgate proved to be UPA government's nemesis after the Comptroller and Auditor General pegged losses to the state due to non-auctioning at 1.86 lakh crores. Supreme Court today slammed the government and its screening committees, which had recommended the allocations. There was no objective criteria for evaluation of comparative merits. The approach had been ad hoc and casual. There was no fair and transparent procedure, all resulting in unfair distribution of the national wealth. Common good and public interest have thus suffered heavily.
The court has fixed 1st of September for further hearing.
Both Congress and the BJP saw the verdict as vindication of their stands.
That is precisely what we have been saying all along. So therefore, if the Supreme Court has come to a conclusion with regard to the entire period from 1993 to 2009, and the conclusion is uniform in nature, it obviously vindicates what we've been saying.
I can assure you the government is prepared to act quickly once the final decision is made.
Former Coal Secretary P.C. Parakh, who was questioned by the CBI in the coal scam, continued to justify his actions as chairman of the screening committee.
Screening committee, to my mind, at least when I was coal secretary, did not act arbitrarily. We did scrutinize all the applications with reference to whatever eligibility criteria there were.
While it was business as usual in the political quarters, markets reacted sharply to the Supreme Court verdict. Stocks of steel majors such as Jindal Steel, Hindalco, JSW Steel, Cesa Sterlite and Tata Steel lost 4 to 12%.
The Supreme Court will consider the impact of its verdict on the 1st of September. On that day, the top court will examine the consequence of cancellation, its financial implications and the investment made. The court may even appoint a committee headed by a retired Supreme Court judge to advise the court on all these aspects. In New Delhi, Arunachalam Vaidyanathan, NDTV.